uncontrollable fits of laughter. I'm like, man. Cows!
I mean, was crying last
screaming,
night. So.
Cows! There's dancing cows! I was screaming this in my living room. The cat's just looking at me, Kirby. My cat's looking up at me going,
yeah, I see that. Shush. Yeah. I'm trying to watch this.
Sure, fine. There's dancing cows.
Hey, there's the music. That means it's time for Animal Talk. Some of the best doggone pet people on the planet here to help you with your pets, whatever the problem is. Pet professionals ready, moreover, willing to help you out. Don't forget, Animal Talk is for entertainment purposes only. So make sure you check with your local veterinarian and your local trainer when issues do arise. But we're always here with some fun, good advice for you as well. On today's show, Donna and I, we have a whole bunch of fun talking about the Olympics. This is a rewind back to 2006 when the Winter Olympics were kicking off. And also on the show today, it's a little surprise, right? These Animal Talk Rewinds, we have just buckets and buckets of shows that we've done. And sharing them back with you now as part of the podcast from the radio show from years ago. And opening up this episode and listening to it, I was really surprised to hear Joanne Flanagan checking in and giving us a little help with some horses. Joanne was my sister. She passed away a couple years ago. And it was really great to hear her voice. So I hope you enjoy the dancing cows and hearing from my sister as much as I did. Animal Talk is for entertainment purposes only, right? Make sure you check with your vet, your trainer, and we're gonna have some fun. Stick with us. It's Animal Talk.
The Winter Games kicked off last night, and the animal tie-in, you might say, dancing cows on ice.
What?
That's what I said. Did you see the opening ceremonies?
No. I was being a geek last night.
Oh, you were dancing revolution?
No, after that.
Okay.
After that.
Why it gets worse from there?
Yeah, I was watching Battlestar Galactica.
Oh, I like Battlestar Galactica.
Isn't it great?
I love it. Are you the new
the
one?
The new one.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I've seen a couple of the episodes.
I was geeking out.
I like the Battlestar.
Love it.
Is it on right now, or do you have it on
Fridays.
DVD?
It's on Fridays.
All right. So anyway, it was the opening ceremonies. We'll get back to your geekosity.
Well, then I watched The Dog Whisperer, so I just had a night of knowledge.
Yes. All right. Olympic fever.
No.
The opening ceremonies. I know. The opening ceremonies, the Winter Olympics, who cares, right?
Well, the hockey is worth it.
Yeah, definitely. But the opening ceremonies, it was the crazy Italians put this show together, and it was like Dante's Seventh Circle of Hell or something. I don't know. Seriously, there was flames, and everybody's wearing red, and they're marching around.
Is that what that thing was that I was... I pulled up my news or something like that, and I saw some red flaming thing.
Yeah, and then they had guys on inline skates with specially configured helmets and packs, and there's flames that come out of the helmets, and they're the spark of enthusiasm or something like that, and they will appear throughout the game. So they come
is
in
it kind of like a Where's Waldo type thing?
Know.
Let's spot the flame head?
I'm not sure. But at one point, they had the big Ricola guys with the trumpets, right?
Oh,
and the lederhosen
and
the big horns, the big Alpen mountain horns. They had like five of those guys up there in their lederhosen, making the noises with their horns, and out came these big plastic cows. I swear, and they were on wheels. They were like, they weren't real cows, but they were big cows. But they're like full. They're larger than regular size bovine. I mean, they were big. They were big beasts. And there were two guys for each cow, and they were like leashes, not on the cows, but on the bases of them. And the guys were on rollerblades, and they're manipulating the cows. And these cows are dancing all over the place, and then all these people in red, and then the guys with the flames in there. I'm like, this is hell. This must be what hell is. They know. Dancing cows and flames.
Dancing cows and flaming hats.
It was bizarre.
Oh,
it was,
my word.
I just, they try to produce this big show, and I think they overdo it. You know? And then they had this one, they had everybody in traditional dress, like traditional kind of, would you call that Nordic? I don't know what you would call that. Like the lederhosen and the whatever.
It's
so that mountainous,
Germanic.
Appalachian mountain.
Yeah, the Alps.
Things.
No German in your family, huh?
No, no. The Polish.
So you have
the Polish traditional dress. I'm very familiar with that. We did. Yeah. So they had a lot of couples out there like that. But then they had the one couple out there, and the guy had on like a really sharp tux, and the girl had on a big poofy dress, but they were cow patterns. And so they were the highlight dancing couple.
Nice.
And then the dancing cows, and then all the people in the red and the flames. And the,
okay, are you sure you were watching this on TV?
I'm telling you, man. So that was my question.
This sounds like a dream, a hallucination.
I don't know. Anybody have an opinion about the opening ceremonies for the Olympics? The
How
dancing,
do you watch that with a straight face?
I was laughing my butt off. Okay. I just spit on you. I'm sorry. Was laughing hysterically. It was uncontrollable fits of laughter. I'm cows.
I was crying last
screaming,
night.
Cows. There's dancing cows. I was screaming this in my living room. The cat's just looking at me, Kirby. My cat's looking up at me going,
yeah, I see that. Shush. Yeah. I'm trying to watch this.
Sure, fine. There's dancing cows. So, it was really bizarre. So,
I really didn't miss anything then.
I T-vote it for you. So
did you?
We're going to watch the dancing cows later on.
Sweet.
I don't understand it. And then you got the American narrator.
You know, I want to be the fly on the wall.
And the cows represent the joy of the country. You know, and it's you know, the American narrator.
Right.
Yeah. They're now creating a human heart. They did. They created a big heart, and they're a big group of like probably 100 people, and they all this formation, and they're all waving their arms like this beating heart, and it was like, okay, that's
wow.
Freaky.
You know, I'd like to be in on the idea brainstorm sessions.
I would
that
like
went
to be
there.
There with a baseball bat.
Wait, no, I just to see who was it that said not only A should we have dancing cows, but the person who said great idea.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
That guy.
The guy who seconded that.
Right.
Yeah.
That guy needs to be.
he was reading a text on his phone, and someone said, "Let's have lunch at Louis." Great idea. Yes.
We can only.
Ooh, what did I just? Agree?
We can
what
only
I...
hope that that's what the deal was.
There's a Saturday Night Live skit for you right there.
Yeah. Oh, dancing cows. Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
So the opening ceremony is the Olympics. That was, but they're off. So, got my fingers crossed for Izzy, the speed skater. So he's not getting the. Because there's a couple other pretty popular speed skaters
Apollo
because of the big shtick last time when he went down and missed the medal.
Mm-hmm. He's the only one that I know of. So.
Yeah. So
it's only because I see commercials like constantly with his face plastered all over him.
Well, his parents, his parents wanted to go see him, but it's pretty expensive to get over there and to stay there. So it was a fundraiser, and I donated some money to it. They made enough money to make it over there, and
good.
So his folks get to
watch
it.
Well, yeah, that's an important thing to have your parents. Can you imagine going
being
to the
Olympics
and
have,
not
mom
having
mom and dad have to watch it on
TV?
NBC of all things.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. That's not good.
We don't have any NBC affiliates, do we?
I don't know.
Okay, I hope not.
Right. I'm not the one that keeps track of that, isn't that you?
Right. But pets, we're here to help you with your pet.
Other than dancing cows.
And we'll help you with your dancing cows. Make them stop, because it scares Jamie. And I had nightmares. Dr. Brad is standing by to do the tango with your bovine. Hey, it's Jamie. I got to hop on in here and remind you about our sponsor, WearingFunny.com. WearingFunny.com for all your pet parent t-shirt needs. Head on over to WearingFunny.com and check out the vast array of amazing, hilarious t-shirts. Thoughtful, cuddly, and cute for you and your kitties and your puppies. And hey, we take requests. If you have a critter that we don't have represented, let us know. We'll get you connected with just the perfect shirt for you and your critters, showing your love for being the best pet parent you can possibly be. WearingFunny.com. Back to the show.
And actually, I'm the one becoming a diva.
Are you?
Well, I'm just making you go on the internet and look at pictures of me.
You didn't make me do that.
Oh, yeah, I did. I said, you should check those out.
No, you informed me that they were there, and I went looking for them.
Okay, I was really hoping you would.
I know. I know you were.
I'm self-indulgent. What are you going to
do? No, I'd do the same thing and be like, you got to look at that.
Yeah, it's neato.
It's all about me.
That's right. No, I got a new... I DJ at a pop station as well, 96.3 WDVD here in Detroit, and they finally, after 2 years, put me on the website. Mm-hmm. I'm somebody now. It's like, I'm like...
Well, they had your name up there for a while. They just didn't have a picture of you.
It's like the weekend stepchild that no one wanted to talk about, you
aww.
Know? Anyhow, but we're here to help you with your pet.
Dear Animal Talk.
You've got mail, baby, yeah.
We're renovating the house, and one worker is very frightened of dogs, so my Shep Chow seems like a monster to him. I don't really care to confine her and don't want to put her in a bedroom. She'll cry and run out if we open the door. Do you think I can leave her outside all day in 30-degree weather? I know she's a dog and born to be outdoors. However, she had diarrhea a week ago, and we think it was from the southern change in the weather. Can this make her sick, being outside? Help.
Well, 30-degree weather. Do you want to stay outside all day in 30-degree weather? Now, granted, they do have fur coats.
No.
And being that she's a shepherd chow mix, she's got quite the undercoat. They can take it, but this dog has not been used to that.
Yeah.
So this is quite a shock to the system, because this is not something the dog has had to do for a long period of time. If you had weaned the dog into staying outside through colder weather, it wouldn't be a problem, but this is a house dog, and house dogs typically don't get the hair coat that an outside dog would get. So even though there is a lot of hair involved in this dog, it's not as dense as it could be if we were an outside dog.
Right.
So yes, this can cause a problem. This can cause a problem.
Okay.
Their paw pads are not tough enough to handle it. The constant cold with the ice and different things like that. If they don't have built up tough paw pads, then this is going to create a problem. You could get cracking and splitting and, you know, different things, just like what people get. Some people's hands crack and split. Same thing with the dog, with their paws. So you can potentially run into a lot of issues with this. So it'd be better.
You're probably better off. Well, how long are the workers going to be there, really?
Board the dog if necessary.
In the day, they probably take a lunch break, right? So I'm thinking a bedroom and a kennel, because a dog like this, the Shep Chow, can cause some serious damage. I would imagine a dog like this, you'd probably have kenneled up when at night or when you're at work.
I would hope so.
Yeah. Okay. So if you don't, probably a bedroom and a kennel. So that way, the 4 hours that they're there in the morning, the dog's kenneled up in the bedroom. If the door happens to get open, they're there.
She's not going to run out.
She's not going to run out. And then when the guys go to lunch, give her a little freedom.
Yep.
You know, and when they come back from lunch, kennel her up again until they're done at 5, 6 o'clock, and then
well, the other thing too is doggy daycare.
Yeah, well, there you
go. Doggy daycares are excellent for this particular issue. You should check and see who's in your area and find out if there is a doggy daycare.
Well, again, we're spoiled living in Metro Detroit, because just being the megapolis that it is.
We're not as spoiled as some other cities. We don't have as many dog parks as other cities
do. That's true. We don't have the dog parks.
We're getting more dog friendly, but we're not there yet.
Right.
But a lot of
our listeners are in more
rural areas.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So if there is a doggy daycare somewhere around, or even a child care center, you could just tell them it's really furry. That's my ugly baby. Can you take him, please?
What's the disorder where the...
It's probably cuter than most kids, but...
Right. Oh. I thought you liked kids.
I don't like anybody. All right. We've got to be kinder than that, right?
Yes, you do.
Okay.
There's other options instead of leaving this dog outside. Yeah. I would not recommend leaving this dog outside, because this dog is not used to it.
I've called the dog catcher like 3 times on my neighbors, because they have that pit bull out in the back, padlocked to the fence. I know. I've called the dog catcher, and I don't know if he's come out. The first two times I did it anonymously, and then the third time I'm like, hey, my name's Jamie. Here's my phone number. These people are next door, and they're not treating this dog right. You need to do something about it. And, I didn't say that. I just, here's the situation, and, you know, I gave him my name
padlocked
and number.
Padlocked to the gate. Should be a big red flag.
Yeah, and I haven't seen him come out, and the situation hasn't changed. So, I don't know. My heart breaks for that puppy out there. He scares the living heck out of me. Next door, my neighbors have this pit bull.
He's not been socialized, and he's aggressive.
It is. I mean, Donna went out to just kind of see the situation, because I had explained it to her, because they're new neighbors. They've only been here for a couple months. And you know, I heard this incessant barking, and I didn't realize, because I used to have a car parked there, and it blocked my vision. And I was out cutting the grass, and all of a sudden this dog was up late in the fall, and this dog was, and I was like, holy smokes. And I go, that's where that barking was coming from. So Donna went to see the dog, and just kind of, what did you, why, how did that shake out, and how do you realize he's aggressive?
Well, it all comes down to how the dog responds as a new person approaches.
Right.
And most dogs, when a person approaches, you know, they might bark a little bit, or, you know, that's pretty standard in a yard. We expect a little bit of that. Mm-hmm. This is their protection, their area of protection. Sure. They're trying to keep it safe. But when you hear a dog doing that low growl.
Yeah, at first, for a couple, like 30 seconds, there was nothing. And all of a sudden, you started hearing that
growl.
Yeah.
And that's a red flag for me.
And so what does Donna do? She puts her hands on her hips like, yeah, what do you got to say?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
She does that aggressive stance.
I do. Because
so the hands on the hip, that's an aggressive posture to a dog.
It is an aggressive posture.
Is it you're making yourself bigger?
You're putting your whole front facing them.
Yeah.
And eye contact to a dog in dog language is a challenge.
Bring it on.
Yeah, so by squaring your whole front, that's basically what you're saying is, I'm the big dog here, and I'm challenging your authority.
Yeah, and then...
And that's when you see most dogs, when confronted with a human who stands very upright and, you know, has that kind of, you know, more aggressive stance, usually the dog will back down,
right.
And that's when you see the belly get presented, or that's when they kind of do the kissing up where the tail's tucked and they're trying to lick you and things like that. Not this dog.
Yeah.
Not this dog.
I mean, it is an aggressive, mean, nasty, vile creature out there, but
it shouldn't be padlocked
to the fence in the cold.
Exactly.
It makes me mad. When you visit our website, animaltalkradio.com, you can send us emails from there. And we had an email about horses, and we have very limited knowledge about horses. We know they're pretty and they're big. Beyond that, we have to call in the experts. We have to call in my sister Joanne. Good morning. Thanks for joining us. How are things out at the ranch?
Oh, things are just fine.
How are all your ponies?
The ponies are all doing well. Everybody's happy playing in the snow.
Any new critters?
Just ordered up some chickens, but they're not in yet.
Okay.
What about the cow?
Oh, the cow's coming today.
Yay!
Yeah, you go. Oh, see, I didn't know you were getting a cow. My sister, you know she's getting a cow.
Well, Rich called me yesterday to ask about dog questions.
Is this one of the extras from the opening ceremonies of the Olympics?
No.
Did you see that?
No, I missed it.
Oh, they're dancing cows. You got to see it.
Lord.
All right. Anyway, I'm like fixated on these dancing cows.
Yes, you are.
All right. Anyway, they were dancing cows.
Okay, all right. Don't waste any more of her precious time.
All right. Are you out in the barn or are you in the house?
I'm at the barn.
Okay, so it's like 30 below and she's freezing
so
in the barn.
Yeah, so get to the point. Be nice to your sister.
No, I'm going to be out here for hours, so
okay.
No problem.
All right, so we got a question. We got an email about a horse. Dear Animal Talk.
You've got mail, baby. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Donnie, you want to read it?
Oh, okay. People around here feed their horses, cattle, raccoons, etc., with day-old bread and pastries that they get for free from a truckload, by the truckload. I am particularly interested in horses. Does bread hurt their digestion? Does it help with their nutrition? It seems unnatural to me. What do you think? And this is side... Signed, Jen.
So day-old bread and pastries to your pedigree equine? That's the word I'm looking for?
I doubt they got pedigree equines if they're feeding them day-old donuts.
Well,
maybe it's just a holding pen, you know?
They
trying to fatten them up a little bit.
Yeah, ouch. Something. So
the bread would be... you know, possibly you could give it as a treat, because, you know, it does have this high sugar content because the grains are so broken down.
Mm-hmm.
So a little bit as a treat might not hurt them, but as a daily ration, that would not be healthy for the horse. There's not enough fiber in it. You know, they need, you know, 10 to 20 pounds of, you know, forage, you know, hay or grass a day. And then if they're being worked, you know, grains are a pelleted diet that is... There's so many, you know, people in the industry, you know, Purina and Cargill that do all this nutritional research, and, you know, to keep the horses healthy. So I would not recommend that diet at all. You'd be risking your horse for colic and probably insulin problems with that high level of sugar.
Wow. Okay. Well, I'm so glad you had a minute to come on with us. How's everything else? How's Rich?
Oh, everything's going well. Do you want to hear about my cow?
Yes.
What kind of, one, why are you getting a cow? And two, what type of cow are you getting?
Okay, we're getting a cow because
we're not going to be eating this one like we did your turkeys on Thanksgiving and Christmas.
Yippers.
Oh, see the story.
That's a real farm.
This story is not having a happy ending.
No, it does have a happy ending.
For
it
me,
does.
Maybe not for the cow. All right.
And there's a particular breed of cow that's raised on the island of Kobe in Japan.
Oh, really?
Yeah, you might have heard of Kobe beef.
Uh-huh.
It's like the latest rage. It's like $30 a pound in gourmet stores.
I heard Kobe Bryant, too, but doesn't mean I want to eat it.
But bum.
All right. I don't
and
know.
So okay. We're getting one of these cows from that bloodline. So you can't call them Kobe cows unless they actually come from the island.
Right. So a couple Kobe cows, somebody has them off in Texas or something, and they're breeding them. So
what do they call them?
I believe they call it Wasagus.
Yeah, like that's so, probably like loosely translated, almost Kobe cows.
Almost Kobe cows, exactly.
All
like
right.
You can make sparkling wine, but you can't call it champagne unless it comes from that region of
champagne,
France.
Champagne, right.
All right, so
they've got corn in the market.
Yeah, how long do you raise this critter and keep him around before you turn him into lunch?
Well, we're getting a heifer, so that's a girl cow.
Uh-huh.
And she will be about 800 pounds when we get her. She's about 6 months old.
Okay.
And they max out at between 12 and 1,800 pounds, depending on the bloodlines and things like that. So we may actually, if you know, we're having fun raising her, breed her in the spring.
Uh-huh.
And then keep the baby for snacks. It's going to be a work in progress. But that'd be really tough to make a baby and then eat it. That's cold.
Yeah, that is.
But that's a farm.
My sister, the praying mantis. All right. Jeez.
Oh, that's exciting.
Yeah.
Very good.
I like
cows. When she's arriving, when?
Rich is picking her up now, so probably around 3 or 4 o'clock today.
Oh, maybe we'll roll out to the farm and check it out.
Yeah, picking up a farm north of Big Rapids.
Cool.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All right, well, thanks for the help with the horse and the pastries and the lovely, lovely story about your cow.
Okay.
And you definitely find out about the dancing cows.
Yeah, all you need now are some goats.
Oh.
Because you've got the geese.
Those eyes just freak me out.
Oh, yeah, because they have the sideways. Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I love them. I love goats. I want goats.
Cool. Thanks for the help, Joe.
No problem. Have a great day.
Talk to you later. I want everybody gets to sit on a little conversation with me and my sister.
Mm-hmm.
That's fun. All right. At least, exciting,
though.
At least
yeah.
It had to do with pets.
Yeah. You know, Rich pets, called me to ask me about breed ban information.
Oh, yeah?
And after I gave him the information that I had about DNA testing and different things like that, he's like, oh, we're getting a cow.
Hey.
So I found out yesterday that they were getting a cow, so I was very excited. So I cows are so cute.
Oh,
they
yeah.
really are. They're just the big eyes with the eyelashes. So cute. I love cows.
Oh, mercy.
Yeah. You know, it's okay.
They know. They you know.
Yeah, that's what they're supposed to do.
I know. It's just...
But for me, it's even cooler that they're getting a cow from Japan.
Yeah.
Or that has Japanese bloodlines.
Right.
Because I'm just fascinated by everything in the Japanese culture.
Oh, okay.
So they're having a little Japanese cow.
That's very cool.
It's so cool. I have to see this cow when they get her.
Definitely. Going to help you with your pet. Kirby's like all about the studio today. My cat Kirby, he's down here hanging out in the studio. Normally he doesn't hang.
He
but
loves me.
Hear little jingle bells. That's my cat jumping around. All right. And what about your cat? Any problems with him? Is he jumping up on you and you don't want him to? Well, or your dog? We can help you with that. I like to have a little fun every now and again, though. Okay, maybe not every now and again, but
all
like,
the time.
All the time.
That's okay, though.
And,
keeps you young.
Yeah, it does. Who's bad?
It's time for the bad animal joke of the week.
All right, the bad animal joke of the week. You can always send in a bad animal joke. Jamie at AnimalTalkRadio.com, Jamie at AnimalTalkRadio.com, or, you know, call us and you can leave it with our boys over at Genesis, 800-259-9231. The bad animal joke of the week. Donna, what is gray, has big ears, and a trunk?
An elephant?
A mouse going on vacation.
I get it. Yeah. Bad.
Bad
that
animal
bad.
Joke of the week.
Yeah, that was bad.
All right.
You had me fooled, though.
I like that one. Okay. If you have a bad animal joke you would like to submit it, please send it to me, Jamie, at animaltalkradio.com. The bad animal joke of the week. Oh, too much fun. I just, and you hate the music.
I do. I really do.
Part of my love of it is how much you hate the music.
I know. I know.
800-259-9231. But beyond all the fun and frivolity, we like to help you with your pet and give you some good animal information along the way.
I'm getting kisses.
Frivolity. Quite the word this morning.
Yes, all right. It was.
All right.
I was just, you know, for me, that's normal, so yeah, no. I wasn't.
As my boss at the pop station, he goes, can you dumb it down a little bit?
He didn't.
He didn't say dumb it down, but we were reviewing my tape from the week, and he said, people aren't going to get that. He goes, yeah, you know, you can't expect everybody to get those kind of things. He goes, you don't want to talk over their heads. And I'm like, okay, then I have no comedy left. Then I got nothing.
I actually was asked that at one of my old jobs. When I was training new people, they said, you know, you got to speak in terms they understand.
You know, I mean, if I said frivolity, if somebody didn't understand what I meant, you know, I was just goofing, you probably meant, oh, he probably means he enjoys goofing. People are bright.
Yeah.
They learn.
Yeah.
It's my job. I'm a teacher. It's what I do.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's how you learn. You hear it used and
dumb it down. One of the girls that I really liked and intrigued by is this young lady that when I would have a conversation with her when I was done, I would have to go get a dictionary and look up a couple of words because she had such an excellent vocabulary, and that was an intriguing thing about her. That and here's the other thing: used it correctly.
I know, isn't that
when
always
people
great.
Use words wrong?
Oh.
Up the wall with that.
That drives me nuts.
All right. But
or make up words, irregardless. Not a word.
Yeah.
That's one of my biggest
Somebody
ones.
Said that last night, and it went, I went, okay, not so much.
Not
it was
talking
this girl.
To
I was
you
talking
anymore.
To this young lady that I just met, and I'm like, yeah, okay, I guess we're done here.
Yeah, no. You know what the sad thing is? I know this has nothing to do with pets, but
it's
right. my friend's
me
graduation.
Me and you coffee in the morning.
That's
what do you
right.
want?
My friend's graduation from Eastern Michigan University.
Mm-hmm.
The Dean of Education, that was his title, the Dean of Education, got up.
Oh, no.
And said, irregardless. I was in the stands.
Yeah, I guess I'll be transferring.
Way up high in the stands, Grant clutching my seat. I can't believe the dean just said that.
Yeah. You know, it happens.
Oh, that's so bad. It's that is one of my biggest pet peeves, misusing or making up words that just don't exist, except for animalogical.
Yeah. Well, there's a time and a place to make up words.
Oh, sure.
Because I do that all the time when I'm talking to my kids and I'm trying to make a point. And I'll make up a word, and I go, yeah, no, that really isn't a word, but...
Yeah, right.
Or they'll laugh, or they'll raise their hand, like, Mr. Flanagan, is that actually a word? I'm like, no, but you know what I mean. You know? And
I've had to make people look up words before.
You can tell that, I mean, they're really over the board. And
yeah.
Made up.
Well, there's some that, because so many people use it, it becomes a word, and I really disagree with that. Yeah. It's not a word. It's not a word. I don't care if it's in the dictionary. It's not a word.
And one email at a time. When you visit our website, animaltalkradio.com, and send us an email, we help you out with that. Dear Animal Talk.
You've got mail, baby. Yeah.
All right. Here's the question. So there's a free dog to a good home ad in a newspaper. We went, got interviewed for the dog, a 3.5-year-old male, non-neutered English Yellow Lab. He is amazing. He's in great shape. He's huge, very well behaved. So the owner needs to interview a few other people before he makes his choice. He already interviewed a family who he said was eliminated because a little kid was in the dog's face bothering him. A single woman who said, I'm the perfect candidate, except if you had a family with a kid, they may be able to exercise them more. So this woman wouldn't be able to give a dog enough attention is kind of what she tipped her hand to the owner. And then as we were leaving, these people who were interviewing to pick up this lab, as we were leaving, another car was pulling up with the next candidates. It looked like there were no kids. The owner seemed to like us because he hinted about a few things. I'm hoping we get this dog. I mean, he's amazing. I need any advice on somebody who's done this before. Can you help me? I don't need help with dog care. We have a 3-year-old black lab male. We had a yellow, but had to be put down. What's your advice, please, Tia?
Well, you know, this is kind of how it goes. It sounds like the owner of the dog is trying to be responsible and find the best placement for this dog. You know, there's really no way to make somebody give you something.
I know. You know? And it's like, okay, you want a yellow lab? Go to the pound. There's probably another 10 there waiting for homes.
Right. Call a lab rescue.
And if you want, and if you want more of a purebred, call a lab rescue.
And they'll come out and bring the dog to your home so that they can interact with your other dog. Most of these rescues will do that.
Go to your, if you don't have a computer, you don't have internet access, go to the library, because all libraries will give you internet access. Pet Finder, pets911.org, either one of those are great sites that just have pages and pages and pages and pages and pages of dogs looking for homes. So it's wonderful that there's five people in this area looking to give a dog a for real full-time forever home.
Forever home. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, so if you don't get this one, fear not. And two, being a non-neutered at three and a half already.
What kind of habits are here?
You know,
this is a big can of worms.
Blessing in disguise if you don't get this one. Get a younger dog, neutered already. If not, get it neutered. And there's a lot of amazing dogs out there looking for homes.
Oh, so, yes, there are. Walk through any pound and you'll see at least 20 of them.
Yeah. So good luck in your pursuits. And I know you'll end up with an amazing dog because they're all really simply amazing. Just the unconditional happiness and joy.
Mm-hmm.
Like this show, the 1 hour of amazing happiness and unconditional joy. is winding down. So thanks for listening, and make sure you have an exotic week.
And kiss your wild thing for me.
Watch those dancing cows.
Bye, bye, boys.
Have fun storming the castle.
Think it'll work?
It would take a miracle.
Bye-bye.